Football helmet over and play in the corner with yourself.
Get yours. You're going to get yours, Ole.
Not from you.
Well,
see you later.
You're going to get it.
Ernie, thank you very much. Ole Anderson, of course,
there's
is...
There's no place for football players. Somebody trying to block him. They don't have to block him. He's not good enough to be a wrestler. He doesn't belong and shouldn't get his chance. Why don't you be quiet for about 2 seconds and let me talk and say something? You know, you're talking about a leopard doesn't change his spots. You're exactly right. The leopards don't change their spots, and there's awfully good reasons. Dusty Rhodes himself was the one that said it could never be over. You just better give me the credit for being smart enough to outfox Dusty Rhodes. I want you to take a look right now at Dusty Rhodes. I brought something down that I had filmed a long time ago when I saw it. You take a look at what Dusty Rhodes says. His own words. His own words were, it'll never be over. Go ahead, show him.
Let me tell you what, a steel-toed boot couldn't take me out. I told you this day will never be over. It will never be over. Both of them. They both of them. One of them's around. I can't stand it because the other one's always jumping in. Koloff, you broke your chain. You broke your chain. Whipping with a chain. Ole Anderson laying down. Could not take me out with a steel-toed boot. Could not put me away with a steel-toed boot. And I'm going to say this right now and get it through your head. Until you have a broken back. Until you have a broken neck. Until your bodies are broken and beaten. Both of you. This thing will never be over.
Well, you proved it would never be over last Sunday night at the Omni, sir.
Dusty Rhodes' own words, it'll never be over. Well, I remembered all the time. I had to sit there and just go out of my mind when Tommy Rich was in my corner. Stan Hansen was in my corner. Tony Atlas, all of those people. I had to stand there and be with every one of them. What happened to Dusty Rhodes?
We're going to take
see a look. What happened to Dusty Rhodes.
We're going to take a look at Brutus right now. Brutus in action. Here the match is underway at the Omni. And Dusty Rhodes and the Assassins, Ivan Koloff is the special referee. And all of a sudden, Koloff starts interfering in this situation. Gene Anderson, who is one of the referees. And it's Dusty Rhodes battling all by himself. Where were you at this point, sir?
I was waiting for my spot, and here it comes. You look, you watch. You watch. I had to be a little careful because I didn't want everybody else jumping me. But Rhodes was right where I wanted him, right on his backside. And when I was kicking that face, and I said, Dusty, you remember you said it better than anybody else. It'll never be over until somebody's out of this business. And right there, you see Dusty Rhodes down, down.
Well, the Russian Ivan Koloff, I might mention, too, has made the statement repeatedly that he would stop Dusty Rhodes and his date with Destiny. But how can you? I don't understand you at all, Mr. Anderson. I don't understand.
You know, Gordon, for about a year, I had to stand right here and pretend I was your friend. I remember when you used to give me all those little smart comments. Well, now I don't have to pretend to be your friend because I never was and I never will be. And if you step your face in my way again, I'll do the same thing to you. And you can count on it.
Well, sir.
That's sir. Thank you. Sir, you look right here. Here's that mealy-mouthed brother of mine, Lars. Lars coming in there, the do-gooder, the guy that I can't trust. No! Lars is no good, and Lars ought to be thrown out of wrestling. And if there's anything I can do to help get Lars out of wrestling, I will. Lars, Dusty Rhodes, the only guy I can count on is Gene, the Assassin, Mr. Koloff. Those are the people that I count as my friends. Lars is a turncoat, a traitor. You want Dusty, you want Lars, you don't know who you are.
Bad situation here for everybody, but more particularly, of course, for Dusty Rhodes himself. Dusty Rhodes putting his heart, his trust, and his faith.
Koloff, my old partner, finally realized that all this time it was just a ploy to get Dusty Rhodes in the ring. I had to take a lot of hard knocks from Ivan Koloff. I had to take a lot of licks from the Assassins and everybody else. But I wouldn't tell him what was on my mind. I plotted and I planned. It took me almost a year and a half. But finally, I got Dusty Rhodes where I wanted him. nobody knew. The only man that knew was Gene Anderson. And that's why Gene Anderson hasn't been here for a year, because he couldn't stomach the idea of me being in a ring with a guy like Tommy Rich or Stan Hansen or now our own brother Lars, Mr. Do-Gooder, Mr. Sir Galahad. I'll tell you what,
why don't you give us a little relief? Go home or shut up or do something.
Well, I think it's time we listen to some comments.
You just take a look. Because even Koloff didn't know what I had in mind. Take a look. He was completely fooled, as was everybody else. Listen to what Koloff had to say.
This is me. I was given the great pleasure of being a special referee in the Georgia tag team title match between the Assassins, Ole Anderson, and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. I was very impartial in my officiating of this match. At one point, I thought that Ole Anderson and Dusty Rhodes would capture the titles. But being in a cage match, the great American Dream ran himself into a little trouble and couldn't get over for the tag to Ole Anderson. Finally, in making the tag, I couldn't believe what happened next. Ole Anderson turned on the American Dream and started kicking him and punching him. Now, all during this match, I kept the officiating very impartial, like I said before, even to a point pushing Ole Anderson out bodily when he made illegal moves into the ring. Now, I couldn't believe, like I said, I didn't suspect it for one moment that Ole Anderson was going to double-cross Dusty Rhodes. And when he started putting the boots to him, I had such joy, such pleasure in my heart, and my blood ran with such warmth, I couldn't believe this. So I had to join in and started kicking the American Dream, taking my boots off and giving it to my old partner, Ole Anderson. And it was like old times. We were both there kicking the American Dream. I couldn't believe it. Ole Anderson, as rotten as you are, I know at last you've seen the way you should be. And I am so happy to see you this way again. The American Dream laying bloody on the floor at my feet, dragged from the ring, put on the stretcher to the dressing room, to the hospital.
Well, I suppose that makes you proud.
Makes me proud, yes. To be back with my old friends again. For a long time, I had to fool them and go around, like I said, with all these other people. The irony of it all is this. Tommy Rich asked me to be his partner, and I went, oh, yes, Tommy, I'd love to be your partner. Stan Hansen said, please, would you be my partner, Ole? And I said, certainly, Stan, I'm going to be on your side. But I was waiting. I said, how in the world can I ever get Dusty Rhodes? I was going to ask Dusty Rhodes to be my partner one day. And Gene says, no, wait, take your time. 9 months went by, and I still couldn't get near Dusty Rhodes. A year went by, and still Dusty Rhodes wouldn't talk to me, wouldn't come near me. But Tommy, Stan, a lot of other guys, they said, oh, yeah, come on. I rode a few places with them, hated every minute of it. But finally, I didn't have to ask Dusty Rhodes. Dusty Rhodes asked me to be his partner. He asked me, and I went with him one match and two matches. And finally, I said, how about a fence, Dusty? We can keep those assassins in. And the idiot went for it. Dusty Rhodes, if it's the last thing I do, you're going to be out of wrestling permanently. Ole Anderson, I'm going to see to it.
Well, I'll tell you what. After hearing those Judas comments from Ole Anderson, I'll tell you right now, Dusty Rhodes has some very, very strong comments to make and some big ideas for Ole Anderson.
You know, I'm standing right here, you know, a lot of people ask me, said, I told you so. Say, I told you it's going to happen. That's fine. I don't blame nobody but myself, you understand? I have no animosity to anybody but myself. Now, when I was walking through that airport, more or less almost crawling, being begged by some fans to go to the hospital, go to the doctor, say you can't breathe out of your nose, can't get yourself together, say, go to the hospital, honey. Go to the hospital, baby. I said I would not give him the damn satisfaction. The heaviest thing that ever happened to you is getting ready to come down on you. I need no help. I want none. I ask none. But in the Omni, Andre the Giant is going to be there with me, with both the Anderson brothers. And I'm going to bring this once pretty face to the Omni Friday night. And I'm going to stick it right up in front of you, Ole Anderson. And I'm going to look you right in the eye. And I want you to feel what I feel. And remember, payback. Payback is hell, Daddy.